Richard.
Hey, man.
Hey, Tim Heathcock, good to see you. I'm Tim Heathcock, I'm Jordan's father. I've been helping Jordan out with his business, Slop Shop, for the last 3 or 4 years.
So this is Chris and Russell, and they kind of come out with me and help me evaluate.
Okay.
So let's go meet Jordan.
Sure. Jordan, I want to introduce you to somebody.
How's it going?
Richard Rawlings, Jordan.
Jordan Heathcock.
Nice to meet you. My name is Jordan Heathcock. I'm the owner of Slop Shop.
You got yourself a slop shop.
We do.
So tell me what your specialty is.
60s, 70s choppers, survivor parts. Got 5 lifts. We keep the bikes that we're building on these 3. These 2 are customer works.
So what do we got here? Whose bikes are all these?
That's Katie's bike.
Katie who?
Katie, my girlfriend. She's up front working jewelry.
Okay, we'll get to that. I don't even know what that means. Is this tire machine and balancer work?
The balancer doesn't. The tire machine does when I need it to.
What's with the electric? I see there's some new electric here and then some really old crap.
It's single phase. I don't have 3 phase, so my mill doesn't work. And my lathe, I have to, like, hand start it.
Sure you do.
Dangerous.
It's not enough.
Not good. Not good at all. They've got all these lifts, all this business going on, and it's like, how do they even get it done? Well, I'm starting to realize they're not getting it done.
Got a lot of room in here that you're not utilizing. What about the frames up top?
All those I'm saving for a later build.
You got titles to them?
These didn't have numbers on them, so they were all titled to the pan motors.
Is this as sketchy as it feels?
Oh, yeah. That's the VIP section.
Ah, another upstairs to another shop. You know, every time we go up those stairs, what do we see? Junk and stuff they didn't even know they had. I would never have that in my shop.
Try to get down from here without killing myself. So, where's this girlfriend?
Katie, she's right in here. This is her little room. We've kind of got set up in the shop.
You said jewelry shop or something.
Yeah, she does. She makes tool rolls, some saddlebags. She does little things, kind of a little bit of everything.
Right on. Hello there, I'm Richard
Hey,
Ross.
I'm Katie.
Katie, nice to meet you.
My name is Katie Patterson, and here at Slop Shop, I am chopper mama. I also sew some tool rolls for them to sell.
You sew all of this?
Yeah.
Wow, those are cool.
What do you make them on? Because I don't see a sewing machine.
Use his mama's sewing machine out in Flora.
All right.
So then what do you need a space this big for here? Because this is valuable floor space.
This is really just my room. I come in here and do yoga, relax a little bit.
You know what? They have an arts and crafts room. Are you kidding me? It's her room to get right and do yoga. First thing to go, it's costing us money.
Right on. All right. Well, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Killer color on your hair there. Not for me, but it is for someone. I figured it was time for me and Chris and Russell to talk to Jordan and his dad alone, see what the business has been making, losing, what's actually really going on here. You've been here a year and a half?
A year and a half, yeah.
How much business did you do last year?
Sales was about 36,000.
At the moment right now, the business all it pays for is the doors open, you know? And that's still kind of rough some months.
Let's just say that all 5 ramps here are pumping. I mean, I don't know. What is that? What are we generating a month now?
To me, if you had 4 of these going at the least, and you were doing 40 hours a week and you're working at 100% proficiency, it's 17.5 a week.
Right. Absolutely. Yeah.
This isn't like shops I've done in the past that have been an established business that have just fallen on hard times. Jordan doesn't really even have a business. Here's my deal. I like the business, I like your age and being into the old stuff. The problem is you're young. The shop's new, and while I believe in your abilities, I don't want to burden you with a huge financial debt. That said, I'm willing to help, but you know, my deals kind of come with a bunch of caveats. You'll only need to pay me back 100 grand of that, and the rest we'll trade. You build me a $75,000 bike as payment. I want the best, baddest bike you've ever built.
Wait, what? When did this become part of the plan?
And I mean, we collaborate on it, we make something badass, you use your skill with some of the old school parts like that, and we make a killer, freaking old school chopper.
I'd like a bike. Wouldn't you like a bike?
Yeah. You know, something that will be on the cover of magazines, what have you. You get the benefit of being able to say you built it for Gas Monkey at the Slop Shop here. This isn't your standard deal, but this is a good deal for Jordan because he'll get a leg up without all the debt, and me, I get a custom bike.
So first things first. Image Concrete Solutions and Diamatic are gonna have to grind these floors down. Surface to Surface is gonna come in, put down the Rhino Linings Fast Floor Epoxy, make sure that this floor holds up to the traffic that's gonna go in and out of here, and is really easy to clean up the oil. The last thing I need are any delays, but the ramp out front, it's a joke. There's no way we can load equipment into the shop on this thing. So first up, we're gonna need to put in a new ramp that can handle a heavy load. I'm not gonna give them something that's subpar. Concrete. It's all the only option I got. And while I'm at it, I thought I'd take care of the crappy stairs out front, but we gotta work fast. Come on now, because nothing could be done inside until we get this finished.
Yeah, we don't want no voids. Make sure we fill all that.
I'm super stoked that Canton Concrete's pouring the concrete here today.
This is the first time we've done concrete at a job, and I love it. You know what? It's something big, it's something bold. Perfect.
All the way up, straight.
Yeah, this is pretty stable.
So the weather here at Slop Shop has been a little challenging.
All right, lower it down.
So we tried every trick in the book to deal with these 2 days worth of rain and mud and managed to get the build going, just not quick enough.
You can drop it here.
I should be a lot further advanced than I am.
Try to get it out?
I'm not. Let's see what I have left to do. I got the electricians got to finish wiring up the panel, all the outlets, and the new lights. I got Comfort Tech coming in. They got to finish up the air conditioning. I have Painted OKC coming in.
Yeah, let's block that.
They got to finish the inside. Oh, and they got to finish the outside, but they can't paint the outside because of the rain. I got to make sure that Kaiser can finish up their airlines, but they can't finish up their airlines. Oh, that's right, the walls aren't finished. I got Security Camera Warehouse comes in. They got to put up the cameras. Oh, they don't have walls to put cameras in. I'm screwed.
Hey, man, we're ready to hang some doors. You want to get this box out of our way?
I run out of money, I'm running out of time, and I'm running out of patience.
Chris, when are these gonna move?
Huh?
We gotta get the equipment moved because I'm getting backed up with the shit I need to do.
Ay. This one I would call pandemonium.
Coming through.
With all the weather delays, we're just getting the equipment in the shop.
This is a metal fab table for welding.
On top of all of that, Richard's supposed to be here tomorrow. And it's gonna see kind of that half-finished build. And that's what it is right now. Even though I see how we can complete it in the next 2 days, but I don't know if Richard's gonna be able to see that.
Those doors. That's bitchin'. We pulled up, man, I was blown away. Everything's completely changed. This ain't going anywhere.
Nothing's gonna fall through that.
The sign looks great. I love the logo.
I wanted to keep it a little bit simple. The old logo was a little dated, so Image Graphics came up with this new.
That looks great.
I love that.
We had Painted OKC come out and repaint the facade.
Right.
Glass Doctor did all the doors.
And then Sunbelt helped us get all the way up there to paint that and make sure everything looked nice.
Wow.
You guys ready to take a look on the inside?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Let's take a look inside.
Oh, shit.
Damn.
What?
Look at the helmets and built wells.
This is a showroom, so you can always have a couple of motorcycles over here for sale, bikes ready to go. We've got you set up with Biltwell now.
Yeah.
You can carry all of their products.
Great.
And sell them. We've got a full corporate account now with Drag Specialties. That's the one y'all didn't have.
Holy shit.
Unbelievable.
Oh my God.
First thing you notice, we got rid of the yoga space, but instead, you've got 6 full working bays right now, and you should be able to keep them all full at all times.
Oh man, it's bitching. 6 lifts, everything's gonna rock and roll. We're gonna be a lot more organized, a lot more productivity come out of the shop. I mean, if we can't make money here, you can't make money nowhere.
William Goodman came in and painted all these murals on the wall for you guys, specific to what you guys do.
This is a chopper shop. It's something from the 60s and 70s. I wanted to have a little bit of vibe, but I did want it to be clean and be an actual working shop where you can make some money.
What do you think about this?
That's cool, man.
So I'm thinking that's in the same place.
It's almost identical to where it was.
We've got Ranger wheel equipment here, counter, balancer. This should make you money every single second.
Absolutely.
Of the day. Now let's look at the metal shop.
Wow.
Oh, look at this.
That's the new Bailey framing jig. You can make just about anything you want
Absolutely.
To.
Absolutely.
This is like I say, get you some of that. I don't even have that table yet.
And to go along with that, Lincoln Electric crushed it. Now you got a plasma cutter and you got a TIG.
There we go.
And you can actually work on it there and bring it down there to the lifts too. The electricians ran all the new electricity for this equipment.
Wow. Every single lift has the ability to run the welders.
It's all about efficiency and making money.
You've got a real sandblaster yeah. now that we got from Ace Automotive Cleaning Equipment.
That actually works.
If you look at all the blue piping, that's a patented air system by Kaiser. That's your holding tank. This is your compressor. And I guarantee you, 6 mechanics across 6 bays right there will have all the air they need.